What is up? Sakamoto lovers, Beyonce slayed every stage in California in one night. How y'all doing, Sakamoto lovers? Oh my God, did you see Beyonce's performance? I was like, I am so happy that I didn't go to the on the World Run tour because I saw the whole concert in 15 minutes or less. Like, when she got the song, because I didn't read anything. Like, I'm kind of that person that I like to be in suspense about what's about to happen. But that being said, I don't want to read about Beyonce's performance. I wanted it all to be like just silence on the set. Let me get it together. So I was just like, I just want to see. Let me see what's going on. And when she did about the first two or three songs, I was like, she's doing a medley. She's doing a freaking medley. And I was like, is she going to sincerely go through all of her motherfucking songs? And by golly, she did it. And she slayed the gods. And everybody's wig was snatched. And then Wally World for sale, baby. Because when I say that Beyonce reminded you that it don't matter what you're whispering about, what you're thinking about, what you want to say about me, at the end of the day, I am Queen B. And I'm going to show you. I'm going to show you how to slay this stage, slay that stage, slay your stage, and come in your living room and make you go pat out, and then sit there and accept my reward while I'm patting my face. Like, it was just too much for me. Like, I had to just think about it for a second, and I'm not a stan. I'm just still in the fan mode. But I was just like, she's really talented. Like, I tell my friends all the time, yes, I love Beyonce today, but she is a true performer, and a lot of artists can learn something. You gotta do more than shuffle, shuffle, step, and have your people in the background doing everything for you. Like, I mean, she is just an ultimate performer, and I mean, she just slayed it. Oh my God, when Blue Ivy came up there, and they was clapping and whatever, I was just like, oh, she was like, go mommy. I was like, ah! And she went on and the room was real fast, and went on and pucking one on Jay-Z's cantaloupes or whatever. She's like, say what you want to say or whatever, but this right here, we working. We trying to get this together. Like, but it was something in their eyes that really made me feel sad. And I don't know what it was, but I sincerely hope that whatever they're going through, it gets worked out. Because it's something to have to go through something. But when you have to go through it in the public's eye and everybody's whispering and you think you got somebody that you talk to and they talking, it's just too much. So I do wish them the best. But I do want to talk about one more performer. Nicki Minaj. We're just going to act like Nicki Minaj didn't get dry pregnant on stage. Okay. I just wanted to know if anybody else witnessed her getting dry pregnant on the stage, because it happened, and I saw the girl bang her brains out, and then Nicki Minaj, she came back out in a black dress. She was already pregnant. That's why the dress couldn't zip up. Duh, everybody missed it. Duh, I caught it. Oh my God, you missed it. I didn't. No, but seriously, like, I was just like, oh my gosh, like, and I couldn't help but look. It was like I was being mesmerized, and I was like, am I being like hypnotized? Because it was like my anaconda poop. I was like, oh, like, I just really felt like I was getting slapped in my face by her ass. Like, seriously, like, it's a lot of booty. But then when she came out, I was like, and this is the thing, I read somewhere that they were saying that Nicki Minaj kept having, she didn't have enough time to zip up the dress, even in rehearsal. If you don't put you on a bodycon dress and walk yourself out there, like, why would you even do that? So now you gotta do a whole show holding the whole dress. Because when she walked out, I was like, something is terribly wrong with this dress, girl. She didn't finish getting dressed in the back, but girl, the show must go on. So she came on out of there, but I was like, OMG, like, she really has to hold her dress the whole performance. Like, welcome to live TV. But I had to laugh because I used to actually live right by the Forum. That's Red Dak smack in the middle of Inglewood, for real, up to no good. And it was so funny when it was like, and in Inglewood, California. I was like, no, you can't try to say Inglewood proper. It's Inglewood, up to no good. I bet you the wood was like popping, like, for real. I could have got me some serious money. Like, I could have did like a shuttle. I could have let people park in my place when I was living down there. Damn. If I'd have known I could have waited to move. Now I wouldn't wait. Anyway, Sakamoto lovers, this video is definitely long enough. Did you watch the VMAs? Did you watch Beyonce slay? If you didn't, I need you to go to find that video, because she slayed the gods. And everybody's like, is she the new Michael Jackson? No, she's not a new Michael Jackson. She's Beyonce. Let her be herself. Why do we always have to compare people? Ugh. Anyway, Sakamoto lovers, as always, this video is definitely long enough. Did you watch the VMAs? Because I did. I liked them. I liked everybody, actually. Except Kim Kardashian and her sister texting in the middle of the moment of silence. Bitch Boo by Kanye. Get you, bitch. I'm out.
I gained a new respect for Miley Cyrus. Way to go, little girl. Way to go.